All right, guys, what's going on? Coach Kilburn here. Just wanted to make a short video to try to go over some of the projects and tasks in our test one. Try my best to show you how to do them and also try to explain kind of what's going on. Okay. All right, guys, we are in the computer sales. Seems like a lot of people are missing computer sales. So, guys, take these tasks in short steps. Break them up. I'll try to model that for you. On the employee bonuses worksheet, step one, make sure you're on the right worksheet. Guys, even it looks like you're on the right worksheet, I usually click. Sometimes I click a second time. I got to make sure I'm on that correct worksheet. You may be doing all the steps right, but if you're on the incorrect worksheet, the task is going to be marked incorrect. All right, so first step, make sure you're on the worksheet. All right, next part, insert a mixed reference into cell F4. So right away, I know I got to click in F4, okay? Notice there's already a formula going on up here, okay? All right. So, guys, what do we got? Click in here. There's already a formula in here, right? We check the formula B15. Let's find B15, right? B15 is the commission. Right, so here's what's going on. All these people, Sandra, Dion, George, Cindy, Frank, Brian, Adrian, Alan, they are salespeople, right? They are selling computer parts, computer accessories, computer services, right? This is how much they sold. This is their total sales, right? They sold this for the company. They get paid 4% of their total sales. So we got to calculate that, right? So B15 is the 4%, right? Times what? Asterisk means multiplication. Times what? E4. So this is how much money Sandra made. She made a little bit over $12,000 because she sold $306,000. So 12,000 is 4% of this. We want to make sure that this calculates correctly when we autofill down. So guys, really, this is just a autofill question, right? Mixed reference in cell F4, so the formula will correctly calculate commission when copied from F4 through F11, right? So guys, all really this question is, it's an autofill. However, to make sure it correctly does it, we got to come up here to this. And right before the 15, we got to add in a dollar sign. Guys, the easiest way I can describe that dollar sign means absolute, right? Absolute means nothing's going to change anywhere. So when you add in that dollar sign, right, it's going to make sure it calculates everything down correctly, right? So it's just an autofill question. We do have to add in that dollar sign right here. Between B and 15, right? What that means is always calculate 4% for every row when it autofills down, right? So all you really need to know, guys, this mixed reference question, it's an autofill. You need to click in the cell. Add the dollar sign between the letter and the number. That means absolute, right? That way when we autofill down, boom, it's going to make sure it does everything correctly, right? It's correct. Boom. That's it. That's all we got to do for that question, right? So let's mark that completed. Boom. Now we're going to go on to number two, right? On the employee bonuses worksheet, again, take it in steps. Come over here and click. Boom. Make sure it's on that employee worksheet. I'm even going to click again. Now I know it's on that employee bonuses worksheet. Use autofill to copy the formula in cell G4. Where's G4? Boom, here's cell G4, right? To calculate the total compensation for each employee. Guys, look, here's the total compensation row. Here's each employee. Don't get confused by all the things in the question. Guys, it's easy. It's autofill. You're going to click there, grab that green handle, autofill down, right? Why did we not add the dollar sign? Right? Because we weren't calculating by the 4%, right? So since we had to do a mixed reference on that task one, we had to add in the dollar sign. On this one, we're not doing a mixed reference. We're not worried about absolutes. We're just autofilling down. That's it, guys. Task two is autofill. Easy, right? Mark complete. All right, number three. On the parts worksheet, again, first step, go click on the parts worksheet. Which worksheet? The parts worksheet. Click again, right? Notice it took about the second click for it to change. I'm even going to click again. Boom, I know I'm on the parts worksheet, right? Here's our salespeople. Month of January, February, March. Here's how much Sandra sold in January. Here's how much she sold in February. Here's how much she sold in March, right? Here's her total, right? So on the park sheet, remove the row containing the salesperson named Alan. Guys, easy. Come down here, find the row with Alan. Click on the row. Click on the number, the 11. Don't click in A1. Click on the row. Just right-click and delete, right? Guys, look up here. There's a delete option up here, right? There's a delete. We want to delete, right? But in this case, we want to delete the whole row. Delete. Alan's gone. He got fired. He's no longer with the company anymore. Easy task, guys. Mark complete. All right, next one, task four. On the parts worksheet, again, break it up into baby steps, chunks, parts. Am I on parts? Boom, I'm gonna click on parts again, right? Boom, I'm on parts. I'm on the right worksheet. Change the table style to white, table style medium one. Easy, guys, easy. We do have to click in the table, anywhere in the table, right? Excel just needs to know we want to change this table, so we just need to click somewhere in that table, okay? Now we need to go up to table tools design. Guys, look, it kind of highlights it for you. When you click on a table or a chart and something kind of highlights for you, guys, they're kind of telling you that's where to go, okay? Here are some table styles, right? Which one do they want? White, table style, medium one. Guys, if you don't see it in here, right, they just didn't have enough room to show every table style in the ribbon. So you have a more option. So we can see more tables, right? Which table are we looking for? Look at the description. White table style medium one, right? It's got to be something with some white in it. Look, here's medium, right? Medium. Let's see what this one's called. Table style medium one. Would you look at that? All you got to do is click on it, right? Changes the table style. Guys, really easy. Mark completed. All right, let's move on to the last one, right? Task five. On the parts worksheet, again, guys, click on the worksheet, right? Even if it looks like it's on the right worksheet, I click again. I'm bound and determined to make sure I'm on the right worksheet, okay? Insert a line sparkline in cell F4. So right away, I'm going to go to F4. Go to F4, okay? They want us to insert a line spark line. Guys, it's like a little graphic. It's like a little graphic. Look, it's going to show the trend of the sales from January, February, and March. So it should start here, and then it should go down a little bit, and then it should come back up a little bit, right? So think of like a line graph. We want to show the trend in the sales from these 3 months for each employee, okay? So boom, we got to go here. Then we got to go up to insert because we're going to insert a spark line. Guys, look at the hint. Insert. They give you a hint. So go to insert. Right? Here's the spark lines group. Guys, look again. They're giving you a hint. Go to insert and then go to spark line. Insert a spark line. Which type? There's line, column, win, loss. Guys, look. They tell you. Line. So, guys, a lot of times the answer is in the question or the task, okay? So we got to go to line. Now, what's our data range, right? Our data range is B4 through D4. Why? B4 through D4. We're trying to show those 3 months, right? B4, right, colon, D4. All right. And then, guys, our location range is here, absolute F through absolute 4. Okay. Then all we got to do is hit OK. Boom. There's our spark line. Right? We could autofill down, guys, but look at the task. They're not requiring us to autofill down. So we got our spark line. We can hit mark completed. We're all done. Guys, now we're going to grade the project and see how we did.